In Dublin town I was brought up, in that city of great fame. My decent friends and family, they'll tell to you the same. Was for the sake of £500 I was sent across the main. For 7 long years in New South Wales to wear a convict's chain. I'd scarce been there for 12 months or more upon Australia's shore, when I took to the highway as I'd often done before. There was me and Jackie Underwood and Webber and Walmsley too. These were the true associates of bold Jack Donahue. Now Donahue was taken, no foreign notorious crime, and sentenced to be hanged upon the gallows tree so high. But when they came to Sydney jail, he left them in a stew. And when they came to call the roll, they missed Jack Donahue. As Donahue made his escape to the bush, he went straightway. The people, they were all afraid to travel night and day. For every week in the newspapers there was printed something new concerning the dauntless hero called the bold Jack Donahue. As Donahue was cruising one summer's afternoon, without a notion that his death was drawing near so soon, a sergeant of the horse police discharged his carbine and called aloud on Donahue to fight or to resign. Resign to you, you cowardly dogs, a thing I never will do, for I'll fight this night with all my might, cried bold Jack Donahue. I'd rather roam those hills and dales like wolf or kangaroo than work 1 hour for the government, cried bold Jack Donahue. He fought 6 rounds with the horse police until that fatal ball, which pierced his heart and made him start, caused Donahue to fall. And as he closed his mournful eyes, he bade the world adieu, saying, convicts all, both large and small, say prayers for Donahue.